So it's official. COVID-19 vaccines are here. As of this recording, at least one vaccine candidate has been approved by the UK, the US, Canada, Mexico, and may have even been approved by others by the time you see this. But what does this mean for the average US citizen? When will we be able to get it? Which one will it be? And what does all of this mean for the pandemic? Let's go over the frontrunners. The three vaccines currently farthest along in their development and approval processes are all using new technologies. That's Pfizer's mRNA vaccine, Moderna's mRNA vaccine, and AstraZeneca's vaccine in partnership with Oxford University, which is what's called a recombinant vector vaccine that uses DNA. Right now, Pfizer's mRNA vaccine is what's being actively administered in countries like the UK, the US, and Canada. On December 18th, Moderna's mRNA vaccine was approved in the US as well. So, who gets it first? After more than 300,000 coronavirus deaths in the US alone, the CDC has recommended that healthcare workers get priority, as they're the ones risking their lives every day treating those who need to be hospitalized. And although they are first up on the list for vaccination, this first shipment of vaccines we're hearing about is not going to be enough for every healthcare worker in the country to be vaccinated at once. So those on the front lines will be divided into risk categories based on where they work, with those who work directly with COVID patients having first access to the vaccine. Also high on the priority list are the elderly, living in nursing homes and other long-term care facilities, as they are the age demographic most at risk for serious disease, and the vaccination campaign for this population has also already begun. Now, the US federal government has given vaccines to each state based on total state population, notably not by the number of people in that state who may fall into a high-risk group. Then, every state gets to decide for itself how to divvy up its available vaccine doses. So individual states get to decide which of their hospitals receive the vaccine first. Some states are prioritizing care homes over hospitals, or vice versa, and states will have to decide how they want to handle populations like teachers, inmates, and other high-risk groups. So to see how the vaccine will be distributed and to whom will depend entirely on your state's individual choices. But for most of the US, vaccines will reach the general public around spring of 2021 at the earliest. So the US is facing what will be one of the biggest rapid vaccination campaigns in its history. Establishing a reliable supply chain on this timeline is complicated enough, but an added difficulty is that the Pfizer vaccine has to be stored at negative 70 degrees Celsius for it to be stable. This makes transportation extra high stakes to ensure that no shipments of vaccine are wasted because they spent too long at a certain temperature. I don't know if you've tried to keep ice cream from melting in a hot car before, but if that's hard, I think this is going to be extra tricky, especially because it involves everyone from public health organizations to airlines to shipping companies, all aiming to work together as seamlessly as possible. Now, the Moderna vaccine, also recently approved, doesn't have to be kept at temperatures that are quite this low. It only needs to be at about negative 20 degrees Celsius, which still sounds pretty cold, but is actually the temperature of a regular freezer. So hopefully, as Moderna's option also becomes more widely available, it can cover any supply chain gaps created by the Pfizer vaccine's extreme temperature needs. The US, like many other wealthy countries, has pre-purchased hundreds of millions of doses of at least 6 different vaccine types. But as more vaccines become available in the future and more information comes in about each vaccine type and its efficacy, doctors may be able to eventually start prescribing a certain vaccine for certain populations. Now, let's talk about price, shall we? Pfizer's vaccine is around $19.50 a dose, which is around $39 per patient because each person will require 2 doses for the vaccine to be effective. Moderna's vaccine is quite a bit more expensive at around $64 to $74 per course, and again, that's 2 rounds of shots, whereas the AstraZeneca Oxford vaccine is only around $6 to $8 per course. And the US government has announced that anyone on Medicare or Medicaid will be able to receive the vaccine at no cost. So in this next year, it's unlikely that we'll be able to choose which vaccine we get, and how much it costs will depend on your state, your insurance, and which vaccine is available to you, which in itself just depends on supply chain logistics. There's also the challenge of getting people to take the vaccine at all. It's been historically difficult to get people to trust vaccines, even ones that have gone through years of trials. And especially for COVID vaccines, there have been many questions brought up, like, it came out so fast, how do we really know it's safe? Are the side effects something to worry about? Minority groups have been hit especially hard by COVID, so how many people from these groups has a vaccine been tested on? We're getting a lot of information, and we're getting it really quickly. And after the year we've had, it's understandably overwhelming. But overall, our key takeaways are this. One, I know it seems fast, but the vaccine has gone through its safety trials successfully, and all of this technology is based on research that's been developed for years. Two, money is what has helped accelerate this vaccine process. The simple fact is that the pandemic has affected the whole world, and that means the vaccine development process has been prioritized over almost anything else, which almost never happens. And three, we've seen what happens without a vaccine. The last 9 months have shown us what a virus like this can do, so a vaccine can only make our COVID situation better. Even with all of the challenges that are still facing us on a road to worldwide vaccination, it's really exciting to see how science has come together to find a solution to one of our world's most urgent issues. And as more information keeps coming out about all of these important questions we've talked about today, we here at Seeker will make sure we're keeping you updated. It is really heartening and exciting news, but we also still have to remember that the vaccine won't be available to most of us until later in 2021. So until then, we need to make sure we're still doing everything we can to keep ourselves and those around us as healthy as possible. If you're looking for more on the complicated relationship between COVID and race, check out this video over here and subscribe to Seeker to keep up with all of your breaking pandemic news. If you have another COVID question you want us to tackle next, leave it for us in the comments. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.